Hey, horsey people. I don't think my horses can hear me. I'm a little away. I saw them the other day and I wanted to point out this is a... Hey, you better be quiet over there. I'm trying to film. So if you notice Buddy, people always say Buddy changed colors. They think I'm dyeing his hair or something or bleaching it. Buddy looks really dark. And he gets that chocolate Palomino look in the summer. Or in the spring, right after he sheds his coat, because he sheds that long winter coat. So he looks a lot darker, and because of that, it's, I mean, horses, they don't change their color of skin. You can tell the color, that's it, that damn chicken's pissed. You better knock, get out of here, knock it off, get. Damn chicken making all that noise. So you can always tell the color of a horse's skin by his nose. So if your horse has a white nose that gets sunburned, that pink skin, that's the color of their skin. Their hair is going to be a little bit lighter. They're going to get sunburned, or it's going to be a little bit lighter. So, they're more likely, I think, to have white hoofs versus the darker hoofs or lighter hoofs, not necessarily white. But a horse's skin color is from his nose. So if you look at Buddy's nose, he's got that little dark black nose, and that's why when he sheds out this hair, he gets dark, and he's really slicking out right now. Him and Mr. T both are. They're looking a little fat, which is another problem that I wanted to cover in springtime. We've had all this rain, and all this grass is just getting green and long, and I always know when the grass is too green and long. Because when I throw them some hay, they won't eat it. They walk away from the hay, and all they want to do is graze on this fresh spring grass. Now, in the wild, this spring grass is needed and good, because mamas have their babies in the spring, so there'll be a lot of food for the babies, for the mamas to eat, to produce milk, and for the babies to eat. It's good, rich nutrition. So, and the spring grass that comes out, that's why most horses have their babies in the spring. A lot of animals have it that way. So that's good if a horse is in the wild. He's walking. He doesn't have access. They're constantly moving. Remember, they move 25 miles a day in the wild. So all this green grass gets put through their system. They don't stay in a fresh green area when they're traveling these long miles, which you will, you know, they'll go across rocks, they'll go across dry areas, they'll go across rock areas, they'll go to high ground with less water so the grass won't be as nutritious, they'll follow paths. But the problem with having this pasture, like, you know, they're on, you know, this, my lot's 10 acres, but I think the horses are probably on about 8. So that's, you know, and now I put the pond in, so that knocked down some of it. I don't think the pond is quite an acre, but it's slowly shrinking the amount of grazing area they have, which is why, you know, I see people with 5 horses on 5 acres, and you got people saying, oh, as long as you have a half an acre per horse. I mean, I've heard of shit, as long, you can have 10 horses on an acre, and that's fine, as long as you're feeding them. Look, when you start getting small areas and many, many horses, there's a lot more complications than just the grass and you feeding them. The poop, the urine, they're beating down the grass, the hoofs, the lower availability of them to be able to graze all day because they turn it into dirt pastures. In California, I mean, just about all horse stables have dirt pastures. It's very hard to find stables in California where your horses can graze in open land, and they have open pastures like this. Part of the reason is liability and sued, and a bunch of damn, you know, a lot of horsemen who run these barns, they don't want to get sued, and they have these English barns with these women that are all worried about their horses being pretty instead of being horses, so they don't want them to get bit, and they don't want them to get kicked, and they don't want them playing, and they don't want them being friends to a horse, because all that affects their lack of horsemanship and ability to use their horse. So the only way they can control the horse is to lock it up, and somehow they think that's the great fix that's going to make me to control my horses. If I lock it up and I'm the only one that feeds it and I'm the only one that handles it, then maybe I can get them to listen to me. But if I let them out and be a horse for the 90% of the time that I'm not around them, so they get exercise and mental stimulus and they don't get ulcers and they're able to graze and they're able to be a horse, you know, no, I can't do that because then it's just too hard for me. Then I got to catch them, Rick, and then they don't want to listen, and then they want to get buddy sour, and then they don't want to come when I call them. And then when I try to ride them, they want to pay attention. So they got all these reasons for their ignorance and lack of horsemanship and lack of caring for their horse. So what do? They get these damn big-ass barns. They keep them in dirt pastures. The horses get ulcers. They get injuries. They aren't moving. They don't use their muscles. Then they run out there in freaking circles and have them jump stupid stuff, mindless circles and jumps, and think they're called out riding. And then the horse gets injuries, and he can't walk, and he gets arthritis, and then they're calling somebody, and then someone else is always there to pick up the slack of idiots. Oh, well, you know what? It's saddle fit. You need to find somebody to get you. Oh, it's a saddle. You need to buy my special saddle and your horse won't be in pain. Or you need to buy my special leg wraps. Or you need to buy this or buy that. Or you know what? I need a trainer. Or I know physical therapy. You need to hire me to come do physical therapy. Or you know what? I'm a horse psychologist. I'll come over there and do a psychic reading on your horse and tell you that he does. I mean, these are all real things that people pay for in a horse world. And people are like, are you kidding? I'm not kidding you. It's true. I got to move this to the left. They're working their way past this little tree over here. And again, I watch these horses and, you know, people say like, well, every time I see them, they're kind of standing in the same spot. These horses travel this whole area, both sides of the pasture, front to rear, 5-10 times a day, easy, if not more. I mean, if you've just watched how much time I've been talking and how much they moved, they're grazing and they're moving. And if they were in the wild, it would be even more because then they would have a leader that says, I'm ready to go, and they're going to stay with the herd. So they don't have the ability to kind of stay. You know, Buddy can kind of stay by himself, or Mr. T can stay by himself, and they don't feel this need that the herd's going to run off with them and they'll be left out there alone. So they can get a little bit separated. But out in the wild when they're doing this, the herd sticks pretty close. You don't want to be left behind, and you don't want to be alone out in the wild with predators because, you know, horses are smart. They figure out we're outnumbered. We may be able to run fast, but we can't run forever. And, you know, numbers are safety. So, you know, I got to move this side. Damn horses can't get with the program trying to film. So anyway, that's why Buddy changes colors. I've had a lot of questions on it. And again, he doesn't change colors. In a winter, when he gets that really long fur, it colors his dark skin. So I don't know if, you know, because it gets longer, it gets lighter. I'm no hair expert, but I know Buddy gets blonder as the winter goes on. Now he's thinned out. He's got that dark undercoat, dark to close to his skin. And now the sun's going to start bleaching that, and he's going to lighten up as the summer goes on. And then when he grows his hair, all that lightened hair grows out. So he looks light, and then come next summer, when he sheds out, he looks dark. And people are like, your horse really changes colors, or are you dyeing him, or are you bleaching? No, I'm not doing any damn thing to my horses. I'm brushing them and playing with them. So anyway, I wanted to cover that. I thought they were, I had a really good picture yesterday of a Buddy with the sun shining directly on him, and it was just really sheening and kind of simmering out there to where it looked pretty nice. I mean, his colors kind of look okay now, but it really looked good the other day. See, he's getting that fat butt, that fat neck, eating all his green grass. I'm going to have to start locking him up. And when you take horses off green grass, Mr. T's probably getting fat too. His neck's pretty damn. His neck's always big though, but I can feel it. He just gets more. Got 8 acres, and there's that one patch of grass right there that they both want. So anyway, I forgot where. Well, yeah, when you pull horses off this spring grass, now because they're out here grazing all the time, and I'm not locking them up and letting them out so they go out there and gorge, they're kind of snacking easy. They don't ever get really hungry, so they're not gorging all the time, but they're still eating really, really rich grass. So the worst time for horses to eat really, really rich grass is at the hottest part of the day. That's when all the sugars come out. And Mr. T's going to try to hide from you over here. I got you, Mr. T. I think you're being slick. Now I lost Buddy. Sun's on Mr. T. Look at that neck. Now he was looking thin, and I had a couple people say he was looking thin. And I was kind of, you know, coming out of the winter, we didn't have that bad of a winter. But a lot of horses will look thin coming out of the winter because they're using all that energy to stay warm. And their fur kind of makes them look fat so you don't realize it. And I ran out of damn fly spray. They're out there kicking. I ran out and went to the damn store and they were closed. So I'll have to get some fly spray here. Hopefully Monday I'll have to tough it out for a couple days. I don't know what happened to the other mule. All right. So anyway, if I can stay on point for those for when you pull your horse off. The hottest part of the day is the worst time to let your horses eat rich green grass. So if you're going to let your horses out and you're going to lock them up or keep them off really rich green grass, you let them out early morning when it's cool or late at night when it cools down. If you let them out during the heat of the day when they're eating, I don't know the scientific formula. Move these damn horses or... Now I can't see nothing because I'm in the sun. I lost my horses. People be like, you need to get a go cam. You need to get something so you can move. You need to get... Shut up. I'm trying to talk about horses' color and getting them off this damn green grass. Anyway, so spring grass is great. It's nice and green. The horses love it. All the animals love it. But it can get to be too much, so... I'm going to start locking them. It's too wet to put them out in a driveway right now because they'll put big old divots out there and tear up the grass. And then I won't be able to cut it. So it's cut and it's short. And I'm going to put them out there. But because it's been raining so much, it's still too soft for them to be out there. So now I'm just letting them roam out here. But they're getting to where they're fat enough that I think I need to pull their butts off of here and start getting them on a little less rich food, especially during the heat of day. It's only 80 today. You know, when I say the heat of day, pull them off. You're looking at over 80, 85 temperatures. Again, if it's 90, 95, there's going to be more. I think it's sugars and starches. I'm not sure. I'm sure some grassy expert out there will be so waiting anxiously to correct me and put it in the comments. All right, so we'll end that there on Buddy and Mr. T getting fat, grazing, and why Buddy changes color. Buddy, Mr. T, you're good boys! Like, dude, we're eating. Get your butt back in the house and leave us alone.